So now, since we have had the previous clips narrating the background of our discussion, in some sentences, sir would narrate about his career as an allopathic doctor, as a surgeon in the state of Kerala, government of Kerala's health services. I will just let him narrate whatever we should know about that.
The highest incidence of cancer in those days, say 1960, 40, 60, and all that, was cancer of the uterus and cancer of the oral cavity. And in those days, radiation treatment was the only treatment for cancer cervix. There was no surgery, and even for oral cancer, radiation was the main treatment. And in women, the commonest cancer was uterus cancer, cervix. And all the radiotherapists in India, they were all trained either in England or in France. That is Manchester in England or Paris or Stockholm in Europe. So all those radiologists were following that pattern throughout. And radiation was the only treatment in those days for the uterine cervix. In 1970, a Japanese firm introduced a chemotherapy drug called mitomycin. So they gave me a few doses for clinical trial. And in some cases of cervix, that is uterus, I tried this drug for a few cases when the radiation machine was out of order. Surprisingly, I found almost 100% relief, cure in cancer of the cervix. So I started using regularly for before radiation, chemotherapy. In those days, was just the beginning of chemotherapy. This drug, Japanese drug, I tried. And I tried in nearly 300 cases of carcinoma cervix. You know, it was so common here. So there was no dearth for cases. Whereas in Europe and other places, cancer cervix was so rare. But in India, it is very common, very common. Especially among the Hindus. Because the Muslim community is almost free of cancer uterus because of the circumcision that is followed in the male population. But in Hindu population, that system was there. So, cancer of the uterus was very common among Hindus and Christians. So, I had many, many people, at least 10 new cases a day. So, that was it. Nowadays, it is very rare. In those days, it was so common. So, I tried these drugs along with the radiation for cancer cervix. And after trying about 300 cases, I presented this paper in a conference in Calcutta, or Jamshedpur, I think. And many people were questioning my treatment because, see, radiation is the standard treatment in Europe as well as England, everywhere. But why do you try this chemotherapy? I said your percentage of results is much better. See, with radiation you get 90% result. When you compare it to chemotherapy, you get 99% result, which is better. So I said, this is the system. So I published it, and that was published in the International Journal in 1975. And now that is a system throughout the world. Chemotherapy and then radiation. That is the advantage of the treatment, chemotherapy. Many people.
It was unprecedented because we have spoke this before also, and I recollect sir was conveying us how many other countries people would further on quote the experience of sir in this specific condition, because there was no reference. The initial debate was how could you do something that is not mentioned anywhere, but of course he took a daring step, an innovative step.
I could get data reference in the international journal. There was no, absolutely no precedence.
No precedence.
Nobody has tried this system before.
So this is this is one among the many things that was the highlight of his career, being innovative and making sure that he is contributing something that made suffering much, much, much lesser. And sir was in the government service here from 1960
86
no starting from the government service
54
54 yeah 54 to 1986. So these 32 years into the total surgeon effect, and retiring as vice principal of Kottayam Medical College. Yeah, and he has served the entire length and breadth of Kerala in multiple places wherever there is a medical college. And notably enough, even before the RCC, you were there.
Yeah.
Even before the Regional Cancer Center started, I think he was already doing the oncology case.
I was the only oncologist in Kerala in 1970.
Yeah.
Up to 73.
Yeah.
Right from Malabar up to Kanyakumari. Yeah. Patients were coming to Trivandrum.
Yeah.
And Trivandrum was the only center.
Yeah.
I was the only doctor qualified.
Yeah.
In those days.
Yeah. So the idea of communicating this specific information is that he has seen almost all kind of situations, being the singular crusader at that point of time. And so the entire history of oncology in Kerala is just on the back of his hand. This is the message to communicate to the viewer in this clip. So I think now we will conclude this, the professional life aspect, till the point of before getting into Ayush.